All right, ISB 67, it's a CM2250 ECM, fault cage 3568, 3569, and then the SCR inducement for the derate for 3714 and 3712. So you type these into the fault code analyzer on Cummins QuickServe. It tells you to troubleshoot fault code 3568 first. So we come over here, the first step is fault code 3568 active. If we go back to insite, it was active. Scroll down to the second one here. It says check for the software phase on a technical service bulletin on QuickServe, that bulletin 4310705. It just tells you about making sure that the DECU or the DEF controller is updated to the latest calibration. And on this one, it was. So it would be yes, it's updated to the latest calibration. So we go to step 3A, turn off the key, and then you're going to disconnect the diesel exhaust fluid controller harness, the 86-pin connector, and the connector going to the injector or the dozer for the on the decomp tube. And we're going to make sure there's no pin-to-pin short. And this one checked out fine. It was greater than 100 ohms. And then step 4 is turn off the key, disconnect the valve, and then check resistance. And I'll show you guys the resistance here in a second. But as you see there, it says it's supposed to be between 11 and 18 ohms. Ours was not, so we measured 3.4, which I'll show you here in a second. All right, so there's the resistance of the dosing valve for the DEF. Went through it all so I can try to get the best angle for you guys, but just got an alligator clip in there with the actual probe or the lead, test lead from the multimeter, and we got 3.2. All right, as you see, the resistance should be between 11 to 18 ohms. So it is not, so it wouldn't be yes, it'd be no. And we got an internal short or open circuit has been detected in the after treatment diesel exhaust fluid dosing valve. Replace the after treatment diesel exhaust fluid dosing valve. So let me get the new one hooked up and then the multimeter, and I'll show you guys the resistance on it. All right, new dosing valve here. I get it to stay on here all the way. There's the resistance to the new one. We got 12.3. So it was 11 to 18 ohms. So that is within spec now. We'll get this slapped on there and then I'll be back. All right, so I did run into an issue with the conditions for clearing. It says to run a pump override test here. This one here. Once you go through and run it, it would not start. It says give it about 90 seconds to initialize and it kept failing. And the reason why it was failing was because of that fault code. So I did have to clear the codes first and then you run a regen. And I just had to undo a regen here. So there's the inactive fault codes for 3712, 3714 also. So this one's good to go and ready to hit the road. Thank you guys for watching.